Do you know that our skin is resistant? And how do you measure that? And do you know that our skin is highly resilient, that it is very strong? Let's understand how. Now, when I talk about resistance, the skin will not allow any moisture from leaving our body and any moisture, any foreign ingredient from entering our body. That is what I mean when I say the skin is resistant. When I say that the skin is very strong and resilient, it will prevent environmental abuse from affecting our internal organs in our body. Now let's explore the reason how the skin is capable of being resistant and being resilient. Now our skin is divided into two parts. The lowermost part is called the dermis and it is the life part of the skin. The outermost layer is the epidermis and that is technically dead part of the skin. Now epidermis is divided into five equal parts. Now, in the basal layer of the epidermis, that is on the fifth layer, a new cell is born. A new cell which is very full of moisture, hydration and rounded shape. Now, every new cell that is born divides itself into two new identical cells. Now, this process goes on and this process is called mitosis. It is a very important process for cell regeneration. And that is how from a single cell, entire human body is formed. Isn't it amazing? Now, once the cells are formed at the basal layer or the fifth layer, they start moving ahead. They move from layer 5 to layer 4 to layer 3 and so on. And as they move, the moistures, they start to lose and they start changing their shape. And as they move from level 5 to level 1, that is the outermost layer, they actually become really, really flat and they lose all the moisture in them. And now here at the last layer, that is the outermost layer, they're all stacked up in form of blankets or in form of sheets. Now all these cells that travel about are all stacked and are all bound with each other by a natural cement called lipid. Now this lipid is very, very important in holding onto all these new dead cells. Now if this layer of the outermost layer is impaired or damaged, that is when external foreign ingredient will try to enter our body or there is also moisture loss. So it's very evident or very important that the moisture loss should not happen or any microbial infection or any external foreign body should not enter our body. So it's very important that you follow a daily skincare routine to prevent this moisture loss and prevent your skin from environmental abuse and microbial infection. So I hope now you've understood why am I telling you to take care of your skin. This is the natural barrier. And if this natural barrier is affected, then there's a problem with your skin. It will show you signs of hyperpigmentation. It will show you signs of sensitivity. It will show you signs of redness. It will show you signs of flaking. It will show you signs of dryness and dehydration. So it's very important to take care of your skin daily in the form of cleansing, toning, moisturizing and applying a sunscreen, a broad spectrum sunscreen. Now this is Shilpa Sawant, your personal care wellness expert. Do engage with me and share with me your concerns related to your skin and hair. Do like, share and follow my page. Thank you.